Alright, then you apa ni? Factorize this equation 60 squared minus 42 t plus 60. Okay, you akan dapat sama dengan 6 t squared minus 70 plus 10. You'll get 6 t minus 2 t minus 5. Okay, kan student kan? Okay.
Madam, how about the minus 10?
Hello, hello.
Okay, lepas tu kita using, if you remember, in our last class, intermediate value theorem. Okay, oh, mesti ingat. Ini ada dekat dalam chapter 2 masa saya ajar you all last week. Okay. Using the IVT, okay, from the S prime T tadi, the S over DT tadi, okay, the derivatives, okay, sorry lah kalau saya eja salah ke apa, you faham-faham je lah eh, will be zero at t equals to 2 and t is equals to 5. Okay, kenapa? Betul lah kan? Sebab it's 60 minus 2 t minus 5, okay, equals to 0. So derivative will be 0 lah. So kita boleh lah selesaikan sama ni. So kita akan dapat t is equals to 2 and also t is equals to 5. Okay, and then check the derivatives at a test point in each region. Okay, check the derivatives at a test point in each region. Okay, so now macam mana nak check dia? Okay, ni kita buat eh. So you always macam apa, x exists, alright? So you boleh letak sini as 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so now you masukkan tadi dalam persamaan tu, if S prime 1, okay, masukkan nilai 1 dalam ni, you will get berapa? 6 minus 42 plus 40, you will get 24. Okay, 24. Then you can see that S prime T lebih besar pada kosong in this region, X exists. Okay, so you bagi satu lagi angka. Okay, sebab tadi ni kita ada 2 dengan 5 kan? Okay, so kita nak tengok dia pergi ke, like the question said lah. Okay, kita nak tengok dia pergi ke mana? Ke kiri atau ke kanan kan? Tadi soalan dia kan? Alright? Determine whether the object is moving to the right or object moving to the left. Kan? So, t is equals to dan t equals to 5 tu is like apa nama kita panggil ni? Penunjuk lah. Okay? So, now kita masuk any number in between 0 to 2, kita ambil 1. So kita masuk dalam nilai ni, we will get ST is equals to 24, which is sebenarnya lebih besar daripada 0. Now kita masuk pula nilai S prime 3. You can try 4, there's no problem with you, sebab dia masih dalam within the range of 2 to 5. So you can try 3 or 4. Okay, masuk 3, gantikan T is equals to 3, you get negative 12, right? So if negative 12, okay, dia punya sesaran tu, S prime T tu is actually lebih kecil pada kosong atau smaller than zero. So now you masuk pula after the 5, right? Within the limit 2, 5 ni after the 5. So we put S prime 6. Okay, angka dia 6. Okay, here you put it here. You'll get also 24. So at the same time, you can say that this one is greater than 0. Okay, so now, right? Now, okay. So the interval, the intervals in which the derivatives, okay, is positive and negative, okay. So positive dia, negative infinity t 2. And 5t infinity. Okay. This one is t lebih kecil pada 2. N. Oh, teruknya tulisan saya. Dan di sini adalah t lebih besar pada 5. Right. So now, negatif. So kita tengok sebenarnya 2 lebih kecil pada t lebih kecil pada 5. Okay, so now we can say that the object is moving to the okay, moving to the left, right? From the initial value theorem, you can actually find the answer dengan using the differentiation, right, or derivatives, and then you find the where the S tu lah, S prime tu or the derivative dia is equal to 0. From there, you put the any value between the T that you get, or X or T or whatever number that you get. Okay, then you masukkan the nilai, you put the any number within that range. Okay, then you can find whether the object moving to the left or to the right. Right, student? Saya harap saya tak confusekan awak, tapi tak apa, memang benda ni agak confuse sedikit. Cuma tak apa, you take your time, okay, as this is recorded. I will share it in YouTube and you can watch it many times until you understand. Alright. Stop sharing. Okay. So now kita continue with our slides before. Okay, so now we enter the product rule, right? The product rule is also something that you have learned before. So this is like revision to you guys, right? If f and g are differentiable at x, then dfx gx, also we can have it as f prime x times gx plus fx times g prime x. Okay, so this is the product rule. Okay, saya tak ingat dalam bahasa Melayu nama dia apa masa kita belajar at maths dulu. Okay, so the derivative product rule, okay, itu dalam tulisan, alright, ini adalah dalam tulisan inilah fx macam ni. So if the write up is like this, okay, so dia v du over dx minus, kenapa pergi kat question room ngarut ni ajar. Okay, so dia akan write up ni dalam macam ni. So if the product rule, if u and v are differentiable at x, then s and then so is their product uv is equals to u dv of dx plus v du dx. Okay, ni sama saja. The presentation of the two saja lain sikit. Representation of the apa ni differentiation tu. Yang ni guna fx, yang ni guna dv dx. But it's just the same. Alright. Next is the quotient rule. Okay, quotient rule pun sama juga. Okay. If f and g are differentiable, so what is the derivative of f over g, tapi provided that gx is not is equal to zero. If it is equal to zero, then you cannot answer the question lah, because if something divide by zero, it will equal to infinity. So you cannot use this apa ni, way, okay, cara untuk ataupun formula dia untuk selesaikan masalah differentiation jika gx equal to zero. But if it's not equal to zero, then you can use the quotient rule. So if u and v are differentiable at x, and if v x not equal to zero, then the quotient rule will be like this. Okay. Okay. I also give you some apa nama ni, problems for you to solve. Right. Differentiate each of the following question functions. I hope that you guys can answer this. I will share the answer in the ni lah, in the Google Classroom after all of you have submitted the assignments. Alright. Okay. I forgot to tell you guys, to inform you that for the second, no lah, third or fourth intake that just joined my class today or this week. Okay. I will give you until 20th or 21st of November to submit all the assignments. Okay, after that I will close the submission in the Google Classroom. Okay, I give you until 21st. So please complete all the assignments given in the Google Classroom. Okay, kalau tidak nanti mark will not be taken. Alright, but so please take your assignments and quizzes seriously in online learning, okay? Because this is how we are going to assess you. This is the way of assessment lah, okay? So now, the next source of differentiation is the higher order derivatives, right? Assuming f can be differentiated as often as necessary, the second derivative of f is f double prime x, okay? F double prime x is sebenarnya differentiation of the first differentiation. Okay, you can go until nth derivative, which means you can go until 3, 4, 5, 6, until nth derivative. Okay, maksudnya boleh buat banyak-banyak. Okay, not only for the first derivation, it can also go to second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and so on and so forth. Right? Okay, for example, find the first four derivative of the function below. Okay, maksud dia apa ni student? Apa yang dia nak sebenarnya? Okay, so in this case, they want four derivatives. Okay, so the first one, okay, f prime x is equals to, okay, I hope student dah faham tau. F prime x is equals to d function lah, df over dx lah. Okay. Kalau f double prime x is equals to d squared f over dx. Kalau f triple prime x equals to d kuasa 3x df. Okay. Dan seterusnya. Alright. So to simplify, I will write, sometimes I love to write prime lah sebab senang sikit to simplify. So f prime x is equal to berapa ni student? 5 kali 3, 15 x to the power of 2 minus 3 times 2, 6 x plus 10. Okay. Now f double prime pula is equal to 15 kali 2 berapa student? 30 x tolak 6. F triple prime x equals to 30. So f, dia nak 4 kan? So fourth is equals to 0. So this is the answer for these questions. Senang je. Memang senang je sebenarnya. Saja je. Dia cuma the matter of main ayat saja nak tengok you all faham ke tidak. Okay. So find the first four derivatives for the function. Okay. I would like to give you few minutes. 5 minutes lah. Itu pun sebenarnya boleh selesaikan dalam 2-3 minit saja. Okay. Tolong buat sekejap student. Tolong buat saat ni. Sama ke tak? Jawapan. Soal prime t is equals to 6t plus berapa? Kuasa negatif 1 per 2. So we get 6t plus 4t plus e to the power of t. So r prime double prime t is equals to 6 plus negative 1 over 2 times 4t negative 3 over 2 plus e t. Buang-buang dia akan jadi 6 minus 2 t to the power of negative 3 over 2 plus e t. Okay, r triple prime is equals to negative 2 tolak 32. So kita akan buat turun, tak pernah buat turun jelas semua. Per 2 t negative 5 over 2. Plus e to the power of t, which is 6t negative 5 over 2 plus et r 4t is equals to betul ke ni? Itulah salah ni student. Potong-potong jadi 3 lah. Okay, so 3. So apa tadi? Negative 5 over 2 kan? Okay. So ada tak yang dapat jawapan lain pada saya? Kalau takut tersalah kira ke apa ke? Saya baru buat juga ni. So if you guys have different answer from me, please bagi tahulah. Buka microphone tu dan bagi tahu saya buat tu salah. Ataupun you guys pun dapat jawapan yang sama dengan saya. Kenapa bawa mesej ha? Alright. Okay. Betul eh? Dapat jawapan sama eh semua ni?
Okay. Sama dapat.
Ha? Macam mana? Boleh buat apa? Cuba buat sikit.
Sama-sama.
Sama Amir? Awak dapat sama eh?
Sama doktor. Sama doktor. Kuat.
Aku.
Buat kan? Okay. Okay. Bagus semua. So now kita moving on to the next slide. Okay. The chain rule. Benda apa chain rule ni? Suppose y is equals to fu is differentiable at at u is equals to gx and u is equals to gx is differentiable at x. The composite function y, okay, ingat perkataan ni, composite function y equals to fgx is differentiable at x and its derivative can be expressed in two equivalent ways. Alright. Alhamdulillah, sorry. So dy over dx is equals to dy over du times du over dx. This is the version 1. Okay, the version 2 is macam tu lah, kita buat f prime lah. F prime gx times dengan g prime x. Okay, so next. Okay, chain rule for powers, right? If g is differentiable for all x in its domain and n is an integer, then dgx to the power of n is equals to bawa n ke depan gx n minus 1 times dengan g prime x. Okay. So for example, this is, if you remember, this is the example that we used to find the derivatives using apa student? Using definition of derivative yang kat, contoh nombor 2 ke nombor 3 tadi, right? And the first or second slides, right? So now the same question, but we want to use chain rule. We want to answer it using chain rule. So rz is equals to 5z minus 8. So what we do here, okay, bear with me, student. We've already identified the two functions that we needed for the composition, but let's write them back down anyway and derivatives. So we take it fz equals to square root of z. So f prime z is equals to, okay, kalau square root ni kita pening-pening tengok, kita pun tulis dia sebab if I yang jawab soalan ni, I like to put it as this. So that if fz is equals to, buat turun half, bukan z ni, half. Half z to the power of half minus 1, which is negative 1 over 2. So samalah. This is the same, right? So now gz, okay, dia ambil semua ni. Dalam ini saja, gz is equals to 5z minus 8. So g prime z is equals to 5. So using the chain rule, okay, using the chain rule, we get r prime z is equals to fz, f prime gz times g prime z. Macam tadi, so f prime 5xz, fz minus 8 times gz. So setengah kali 5z minus 8. Okay, z ni tadi dia ganti dah balik dalam ni. So kita dah buat jawapan dia ni. So the z is apa ni, substitute by this one. So bubur dalam ni 5z minus 8 to the power of negative to the power of negative half, right? Times 5. So inilah jawapan dia. 5 over 2 square root times square root of 5z minus 8. And this is the same as when we use the definition of the derivative. Okay? Okay? So maknanya dia asing kan? Okay? The chain rule. Okay? Find the derivatives of the following functions. Alright? Okay? Since we have few minutes, I will give you like 5 to 10 minutes to complete this. Okay? Please don't sleep, students. Sebab you pun tutup you punya kamera, saya tak tahu you tengah buat apa, but please take some time to buat ni. Okay, nanti kita share jawapan dia apa. Okay, I give you 5 to 10 minutes sampai benda ni hilang, dan kita akan masuk for our last class lah. Okay, tapi biar dulu kat sini. Okay, buat cepat student.